What's going on? It's Facts You Don't Know. If it's your first time here, and you want to find out new facts that will definitely make you smarter and more well-informed, make sure to subscribe and activate the notifications bell so you don't miss anything.
From ancient times and since the emergence of civilizations, animals had a special place in the lives of people, as they were accompanying them wherever they went, as they were a source of sustenance and a main food for them. And animals to this day have many blessings for man, as he moves from one place to another, carried on his back, and eats from its meat, worn from its wool, drinks from its milk, and helps it in the work related to the land. Therefore, we have to be gentle with it. That's why a person must help the animal if he finds that he needs it. Sometimes animals fall into danger, and the human being is the only being able to take them out of their predicaments that fall into them, because it's simply the only being on this earth that possesses the mind and who can think it out to safety. Below we'll show you this exciting story, which shows how a person helped a large number of bats after they were confused and did not find a shelter to protect them from the coldness of the cold. Residents noticed that there were a large number of bats on a balcony of a house on the street where they lived, which surprised them because usually people rarely meet bats face to face, let alone this huge number of them. And it became clear later that these animals decided that she spent the cold winter in a warm place and found that the balcony of that house was suitable, which made them choose for this. When environmental experts in that area learned of the existence of these bats, after the police told them, they decided not to leave them there because they'd be in danger. If temperatures drop further, this will cause them to be unable to resist and they can die from the cold. Biologists from the National Academic Institute of Science in Ukraine, headed by the scientist Andrei Taras Pashto, described these creatures as extraordinary and decided to transport these bats to their center in order to check on their condition and to take care of them until they found a solution for them. When those bats were counted, it turned out to be more than 1,700 bats, which is a huge number, as it's rare for such a large number of bats to gather in one place. So when he noticed those bats that decided to settle in the balcony of his house, he took a video clip for her, then immediately contacted the policeman who came to the place, and then contacted the Institute of Biology. And then the experts came from there with cages where they put the bats in. Then they transferred them to the Bat Care Center. There they took some care and fed her well. The number was very large, and the bats have their own food that the center cannot provide for that huge amount of them. As is known, bats are bloodsuckers and they feed on insects, fruits, and nectar. As they eat meat by preying on small animals, such as birds and fish, and these foods can only be obtained in nature. When these researchers confirmed that the bats were in serious condition and could take care of themselves on their own, they moved them to the woods and cleared them there, so they might find a better place to spend the winter. Mostly, she'll head to the mountains, perhaps finding caves there to spend the cold winter. Fortunately, the weather in those days improved, which would give time for the bats to find suitable places to escape the freezing cold. Contrary to what's commonly believed, bats are peaceful and do no harm to humans. Although it's a vampire, but this is with some other animals such as weak birds, insects, and mollusks. But in reality, it's rarely exposed to humans. There are many rumors circulated about this hateful creature for many people, as it lives in darkness and caves and mountains. And unlike many people, it sleeps during the day at the time of activity and is healthy at night to feed and sleep suspended by the bishop and branches. And there are different types of it, and not for everyone dangerous, but rather the sucking type blood has some danger to humans. But according to a number of studies that were done on these creatures, human blood was found despite not being adapted for that. They feed on insects. Thanks for watching. Please like and share the video in social networks. We'll be right back to you as fast as we can.